Delaney, and welcome to my channel. How are you guys doing today? Leave it down below. You know I love hearing from you. So if you are new here, you might have missed that I am doing 3 weeks of reviewing super hyped fragrances because the launches are crazy lately. There are so many new fragrances coming out and oftentimes lots of hype that comes out about fragrances, and I want to get my nose on all of them. But your girl's on a budget, and I'm really trying to not overdo blind buys anymore. I want to be wise with my money, so you know I had to pick up some samples. So I will link down below my review of Gucci Gorgeous Orchid, my review of Navitus Cabana Sunset, and today we are talking about one that I was so curious about because I had heard so much talk here on YouTube and just people raving about it that I was like, hold on, is it that good? So I did pick up a sample of Wave Child by Room 1015. I cannot lie, I was so intrigued because there is a watermelon note in here and I love watermelon. So if you want to hear my review of Wave Child and you enjoy beauty content, little lifestyle content, and a whole lot of fragrance content, make sure you click that subscribe button, join the fam, you won't regret it. Now let's get going. So I went through this sample, like I have probably used 60% of it, maybe a little bit more. I just heard so many people talking about this, about how good it was the best one from the house. The hype was so real with this one that I was like, I need to smell it so badly, and it has a watermelon note. First of all, watermelon is my favorite fruit in the summer. I almost always have watermelon in the fridge when the season hits, and I want to smell like a yummy watermelon, but it is so hard to find a watermelon fragrance that I really enjoy because oftentimes they're just kind of meh, fun, playful, watermelon, candy-like, because this has some interesting notes in there. Top notes of mandarin orange, lemon, and some more orange. Middle notes of watermelon and coconut, and I thought it was kind of interesting that the watermelon wasn't in the opening, it was in the middle, so I was like, maybe it will last a little bit more and kind of carry on into the dry down. Then the base notes really intrigued me. Ambergris, cacao, and amberwood. I love amberwood fragrances. Like, I didn't know what to expect at all from this. And then the accords were kind of interesting. They are starting with ozonic, aquatic, citrus, then going into coconut, amber, sweet, fruity, animalic, and lactonic. Animalic scares me sometimes because on me, a lot of times, animalic can go a little stinky. So I was like, this one really is going to be a mystery, so I had to try it. And honestly, I love this fragrance. This is gonna be my scent of the day. That opening is so pretty. That opening is like a very soft, yummy, fluffy cloud. It is very ozonic in the opening, like fresh blue skies with the fluffiest white clouds you've ever seen. It's sweet, but it is not cloying. There's just enough freshness in there that I think this works in the summertime. It's interesting because it's more of like a kind of laundry fresh than like a citrusy fresh, even though there's so many citruses in the opening. I get the watermelon like basically with the first blast, and I do think the watermelon carries on in the fragrance for a decent amount of time. In the deep, deep dry down, I don't know if I fully still get watermelon versus like a soft sweetness coming from the watermelon. After that very fresh, ozonic, soft clouds, blue sky opening, then that watermelon comes out even stronger. And then that coconut gets in there, and the coconut makes it very creamy. I can tell it's a coconut, but I wouldn't call this a coconut fragrance. This doesn't go sunscreeny or anything like that. It's like a sweetened coconut milk, like maybe a sweetened condensed milk made with coconut milk versus regular dairy. It honestly plays really beautifully with the watermelon. The way the sweetness and the creaminess play together remind me a lot of Melon Kiss by Navitus. If you've smelled that sweet creamed honey and that coconut, it really does in that mid remind me of Melon Kiss. The base notes are so intriguing, and this is an interesting and fun fragrance in the fact you really do get the opening, the mid, the dry down. This one takes you on a journey, which is always fun. Those types of fragrances aren't for everybody. It takes a little bit more getting used to because it does change throughout the wear of the fragrance. Opening, very fresh laundry, sunny skies and clouds, blue skies. Then that mid is that very rich, ripe pulp of the watermelon with that sweetened condensed coconut milk that makes it so creamy. The ambergris makes it a little summery. There is something a bit beachy to this without being in that sunscreen realm, but truly I think you could wear this all year because it is such a rich fragrance. I think this could still play well in cold and dry winter months here in the Midwest. The ambergris, I feel like, makes this a thick fragrance, but it also kind of radiates off the skin in a soft cloud. There is still a softness to this fragrance. It's a very velvety fragrance. That amberwood definitely plays up in the base. I think it brings out more of that candy-like sweetness where the watermelon starts to tame some and you're not right away like, oh, watermelon, but it's still sweet, rich, candy-like. And then to me, the cacao really makes it velvety, smooth, a little mysterious and deep and sexy. As I was living in this fragrance, it also kind of reminded me of Indigo Valley by Skylar. That is a blueberry mocha. So you've got that foamy milk with the sweet fruitiness from the blueberry and then the cocoa from the mocha. And it also, to me, wears in a very velvety, foamy, type feeling when you're wearing it, like a whipped latte. I get something very similar to this. I could definitely see this being unisex. I can sometimes get steered away from unisex fragrances because I really do prefer feminine leaning, but this one is fairly down the middle. The sweetness makes it maybe two toes, three toes into feminine, but the right guy could definitely wear this and feel very confident in it, especially in that dry down. It really brings out a kind of a powerful energy in a way. It's like a soft powerful. It's not, you know, I'm here and I walk heavy and I boss people around, but it's like, no, I'm confident in myself. I am powerful without having to be a bully. So there is a powerfulness to this fragrance. It's something you can really feel confident when you're wearing it. I do think it's one that, for me, as far as longevity goes, if I was wearing it to work and then wanted to go to an event after work, I would have to pop this in my bag and reapply. Definitely not my longest lasting fragrance. It would be worth the reapplication and going through the fragrance journey again because I love the opening, the mid, and the base. As far as projection goes, I think this one is fairly close to you. I don't think you're gonna knock people out, but I do think people are gonna smell you. I kind of wish, in a way, the watermelon stayed a little bit longer because I purchased the sample because I wanted that watermelon. But truly, I love the dry down of this so much that the dry down makes it worth it for me, truly. Have you guys tried Wave Child? If you have, leave your thoughts down below. I'm so curious to see what everyone else thinks because this was such a hyped fragrance here on YouTube. So leave your thoughts down below. All right, guys, I will see you in the next one. And as always, please try to stay positive because at the end of the day, that is truly all we can try to do. I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.